Morning, Al Ingalls here at alingalls.com with an interesting little show today. As I was walking out here in the forest today, I was thinking back to our house in Battle Creek and remembering a time when my eldest was two. He was only 2 years old, and we kept seeing this little boy riding past our house on this little tiny old bike, riding past it with just a tiny little pair of shorts, no shirt, and he was just riding by our house. And one day, we had a big fenced-in yard with a gate. We let that little boy in to come play. Now, he was seven, and our oldest was two. Ned wasn't even born yet. And this little boy claimed Hugh as his best friend, right? He's 5 years younger, but Hugh could actually play basketball with 16-year-olds. So he didn't think he was two. So it's kind of a fun relationship. And more kids from the neighborhood. We lived on a corner with three very different neighborhoods, upper middle class, lower middle class, and then really pretty extreme poverty. And every kind of kid played in our yard. Every kind of kid felt welcome there. And so as my husband and I, like, you know, suddenly becoming the neighborhood park, we put a few rules into place that are kind of different than most parents would put. Like, kids could do a lot of things in our yard that probably couldn't do at home, like play in the mud and other things. But here were a couple of the rules that were really impactful. One was no name calling. So like, you couldn't make fun of somebody else or call them a name. And, you know, I'm talking about real subtle things. Like, I've heard people have been called names. My clients, you know, other people will tell me, like, my dad always called me turkey brain, or there's all kinds of real derogatory things that people have been called. And so we had a rule that there was no name calling. Another one of our rules that we play to the youngest, or someone out there plays to the youngest. Typically the youngest was going to be one of my kids. It was like babies, you know? And there's incredible video footage of this boy that I shared, this boy Bobby. So he would have been about eight at the time because our second was born, but he was just little. He's playing with the youngest while all these other kids are playing football in the yard. So play to the youngest and no name calling. Those are pretty much the two big words. And also let your mother or guardian or whoever's taking care of you know where you are, that you're playing down at the Ingalls house. So those were our three rules for all these kids who used to play in our yard. And one day, little Bobby says to me, the original little kid, he goes, Mrs. Ingalls, we call your house the safe house. And I was like, the safe house? He goes, yeah. And he said, because there's no name calling. And this little boy was small for his age. And he was kind of a jokester, you know, probably known as the class clown in his class. That would be a name calling thing, by the way. And he said, yeah, at school, I just get picked on so much. And so here he felt safe. This was the safe house. And we were taking a lot of home video. This little boy has seen so many home videos. My husband had him write a play, and they acted out the play. Like, so many cool things. They had plots in our garden. We had a huge vegetable garden, and these different kids would have their own. What do they want to plant? I want to plant carrots. I want to plant lettuce. You know, whatever they wanted to plant, my husband, you know, we'd let them have their little place in our garden. So we did all kinds of really unique things with these kids, in addition to every kind of sport. From we had an adjustable basketball hoop. So whatever size they were, we had three hoops in the yard. Anybody could play, any age. And so I just wanted to share today, you know, is your home a safe house? Is your neighborhood a safe neighborhood? Do kids feel like they can be there and just be themselves and not have to, you know, what are the expectations? Sometimes expectations for our children today are so high that they feel like failures from a really young age. They're not doing well. They have test anxiety. There's so much anxiety. So it's been really great to provide that not only for our own kids, but like all these little kids used to play at our house. This idea that you're okay, just the way you are. And now we can learn because we're not all stressed out. So that was my thought today, you know, creating a safe house. And I'm going to continue my journey here, this beautiful forest where I love to walk. You know, it's safety is one of Maslow's hierarchy of needs, basic needs. And yet so many people today do not feel safe. They don't feel safe in their homes. They don't feel safe in their neighborhoods. So somebody's got to step up, takes a village. Can you be a little safe haven for someone? And maybe, you know, you got a big porch and everyone can come and read books in the summer in the shade. You know, just something fun. So I loved that our house was a safe house for our own kids, for their friends, for anybody who wanted to come over. People knew they were always welcome and could drop in any time. In fact, after one of my sons, my eldest, went to college, one day this kid just walked into the house. I was glad I was decently dressed. And he was like, "Hey, Mrs. Ingalls, I was just missing you. I wanted to come see you." So obviously we were a safe house for him too, even at the age of 18. Everybody needs it. We all need to feel that we're okay and that we're safe. And yeah, so that's my little message. I hope you have a great pressure-free day and enjoy, at least in Michigan here. I think in other parts of the country, it's just a gorgeous day. Have a good one. Bye.